What is Liebig's law of the minimum, or the barrel theory? The law states that the growth of a plant is controlled by the scarcest resource, not by the total amount of resources available. Resources can come from the soil, such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, or it can come from other places, such as sunlight. The law of minimum states that the plant is dependent on all of these resources combined, not just the plant's ability to absorb a few of the resources, such as nitrogen or sunlight. Justus von Liebig first popularized the idea of the limiting resource as the defining factor of plant growth in 1840. Liebig was a world-renowned chemist and believed that chemistry could revolutionize agricultural practices to increase yield while decreasing costs. Liebig forefronted conservation practices, advocated for the recycling of sewage, and helped discredit the idea that humus, dead plant material such as leaves and twigs, was the primary source of carbon obtained by the plant. We now know that carbon is obtained through the atmosphere. Liebig's law of minimum is commonly referred to as the barrel theory, since the same concept applies to wooden barrels and their slats. Picture a barrel full of water. If each slat is complete, then the barrel will hold the maximum amount of water. However, if one of the slats is incomplete or shorter than the rest of the slats, the water will flow out until it is at the top of the shortest slat. The capacity of the barrel is not determined by the longest slat, but by the shortest slat. Now picture that each slat in the barrel is a different resource. We'll use nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and sunlight, but there are plenty other ones as well. The water in the barrel represents the plant's ability to grow. If all the slats are complete, then the plant will grow to its fullest potential. This is, of course, disregarding variables such as weather, predation, and disease. But if one of the slats is incomplete, the plant will only grow as well as the limiting factor allows. In this case, phosphorus is the limiting resource, so the plant will grow much smaller than if it had sufficient phosphorus. In order to correct this, a farmer would need to add the resource that is deficient, but only enough to balance with the other resources. If the farmer overcorrects this deficient resource, a different resource would then become the limiting factor, in this case, potassium. The farmer would have wasted time and money supplying the deficient resource. Farmers around the world, regardless of organic or conventional farming practices, now understand that in order to maximize the yield, they must keep a well-balanced soil and that the unbalanced soil does not supply the necessary resources to grow a plant to its fullest potential.